G'day guys, back again. Hope you're all doing well. I went down to my dungeon the other day and I was looking around for something for the moose. I think it was my Dremel I was looking for the moose. Anyway, I stumbled across this little bust. And I've had this for a long time. And as I've said before, and I'm kind of contradicting myself a little bit now, I really don't do many busts and I don't buy a lot of busts either. And but I saw this one, and just because it's old and it's Valinden, and you don't see too much of Valinden stuff around or see many videos of it around, so I thought I'd just show a quick little video of this little bust here. Now, obviously, this is from, I always get confused, but it's Desert Storm / Desert Shield, and this one's 200mm bust from Valinden, and Valinden's done a couple of hit and misses with the Desert Storm, Desert Shield figures. Some of them are quite nice, especially the 120mm, I think it was the 60 MG, it's so long ago, I'm used to the Saw and the 240B and all that. Is it the M60? I think it's the M60 guy, 120mm. And there's a Special Forces guy who looks a little bit funny. And a couple of the other Valinden figures. Some of them, are, one or two, are quite nice. I think the guy with the Coke can. And has he got an M16? With a rocket grenade launcher on the end of it. Is that a 240? I can't remember. But anyway, this one's not too bad as a bust, I thought. So I picked it up. God, don't even ask me when, quite a long time ago. And I thought we could just have a quick look at it because I think it is a reasonably nice bust when it comes to Valinden figures. So we can start off with the main part, obviously, is the torso. And as you can see here, I mean, you do get the benefit of it being 200mm. So obviously it's a lot larger in size, so then you get more detail. But the actual the torso is done very nicely. And I always get confused with these figures because it's a bit hard to tell, but there is a, I think there's a, whatever you want to call it. I wasn't in Desert Shield or Desert Storm, but I think it's a little flak vest that's on. And it sort of goes over the top here and around the side. And I think that this is just your normal uniform underneath here. If I can show you like that, it sort of comes over the top. And then that's just your normal uniform underneath the flak vest or whatever. And you can see the collar as well. But as I was saying, the one thing about Valinden is that the casting on pretty much most of his figures that I've got anyway was really well done, especially for its time. It wasn't brittle, and it was sort of just all this sort of colour, which really reminds me a little bit of, not my childhood, but quite a few years ago, this sort of khaki Valinden colour, whatever you want to call it. But you can see the back here. Really nicely done, and you know, like some resin figures, some of the buckles are chipped off or broken and they sort of need repairing. A lot of the Valinden figures, because of the resin he used, I didn't really come across that much with a lot of his figures. It was obviously strong or not brittle resin. And as you can see, this here kind of is a bit of a painter's dream, really. There's really not any cleanup really much to be done on this at all, which is fantastic. I mean, you've got a little bit, you can see under here, there's some air bubbles, but you're not going to see that. And a little bit of, just a tiny little bit of file around there for a couple, like a minute or two, and that's all done. And pretty much you're ready to start painting this. And you do get a little stand here for this little bit to sit on. For this little bit to sit on here, like so. Now, I haven't done it this time, guys, so you'll have to forgive me because I'm not going to chop this off. But I'll put the head in there for you. And I don't know if you guys will sort of notice, but the head is quite nicely done. There's quite a lot of detail around the cheeks. His teeth are there. And even with the eyes, there's some, whatever you want to call it, his eyeballs or his iris. The black parts of his eye there are done as well. I don't know if it'll show up on camera there. But again, the connection to the actual collar and the neck that fits in there perfectly. Really strong connection. And obviously he does look a bit like, I don't know, he reminds me of an American politician with his hair like that. I can't remember. Maybe it's from, is it Dick Cheney? And Russell Crowe playing him or something like that. There's something about that reminded me of Russell Crowe playing Dick Cheney or whatever his name is. Anyway, so I think the head's really nice. I think the torso's really, really nice as well. The helmet, again, as I said, I haven't worn this uniform, but I actually do like the helmet. There's a lot of creases in the helmet. Because this is a cover. Let's go with cover. A cover actually put over the top of the helmet. For some reason, I've always liked the Desert Storm uniform. There's something about it that, I don't know, like the modern uniforms today with the pixel stuff and that, from a modelling point of perspective, I'd take a Desert Storm uniform or the three-colour tone woodland or something over the newer pixel sort of digital uniforms. A lot easier to paint. And the only thing is that I kind of wish in one way they didn't have this resin block over the top of the helmet there. And maybe they'd put it underneath the back, like a lot of the new modern figures do that now, so you don't mess up the curvature of the helmet. But one thing I will say is the little indentations here, or the breathing things in the cover here, they're not messed up, so it sort of is nice that it's sort of straight through the center and doesn't interact with any of those sort of, these sort of little, I'm not sure what you call, little cuts and whatever you want to call it in the cover of the helmet. I think that this is probably one of the nicest busts that I've got that Villindon's done, and I picked it up and I'm not really that disappointed in it, to tell you the truth. You do get a little bit of extra equipment here that is on the cover of the box art there. I don't know what that is, guys. Is it the smoke grenade? I think there's a couple of different types or colours of those, and a little pouch up the top there with the US symbol on it. Now, at the start, before I looked at this, I was kind of a little bit cranky with the head, because I was sort of looking at the head and going, oh, you know, geez, that's a pretty nice head. And I was like, well, hang on. You know, the bloody strap doesn't go all the way up to the, the top of the helmet. When I was putting it on, I thought, well, that's not going to reach there. And then it was only after I actually picked this up that I actually realised that you've got the rest of the straps here. Which is quite nice in one way, because I think it's a little bit more realistic in the fact that it's not stuck to his head. It's actually coming off, if you can see on the angle there, and going towards his helmet on each side. So it's not sort of just running up the side of his head, stuck to the side of his head, and then, you know, not attached to the helmet. Just looking at this head, for some reason, it does remind me of, and I don't know his name properly, guys, but is it Gollum from Lord of the Rings, or is it Spiegel? I don't know his name, but for some reason, when I first looked at the head there, I think it's the teeth. The teeth sort of remind me of Lord of the Rings, that little character in Lord of the Rings. And even here, I think without the head on, he does remind me of that just a little bit. But I am being pretty picky. But all in all, just for a very simple bust, and I'd say if you like busts and you just want to get into painting, and you want to paint a Desert Storm figure, I think this is a great one to start with, especially if you're just trying to get the uniform colour down right and put some nice washes. And again, I'm not 100% sure, and maybe someone can chime in. Maybe one of the Americanas out there can chime in and say, I'm pretty sure, but I'm not 100% sure, because I could be wrong, that maybe you could do this flak vest in a woodland colour as well, and the uniform in the Desert Storm sort of, you know, colours. But I could be wrong, because I was reading it up a while ago about that, and I wasn't sure if someone was saying it did come in the woodland colours or it didn't for this type of vest. So I have to check that up if you're thinking about doing that. But that's also a nice combination to give you a couple of different colours. But yeah, that's pretty much it for this one, guys. If you're looking at it there, there's the Villindon number. And I think there's someone on eBay now who's bought the moulds to Villindon stuff. I can't remember which shop it is, but they do sell quite a bit of Villindon stuff there, which sort of is good in a way, because you can still pick some of the stuff up. But in another way, I think you just got to be careful. Some of those eBay shops, some of the Villindon stuff seems quite cheap, and then you look at the postage costs that they're charging you, and it's a bit of a rort. So just be aware, if you get on eBay and you're looking at picking up some Villindon stuff, double check the postage, because at times I've seen something like this and say it might be $20, but then they put the postage at about $50. So it's a rort. It's a rort. So just be mindful of that when you're checking out some of the Villindon stuff. But other than that, guys, I quite like this little bust. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll catch you later.